Los Angeles Clippers. It was a loss to Washington at the Verizon Center. It'll be Los Angeles off the tip. And the Clippers starting five. CP3 at point with Redick there at the back. Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. And it's Barnes and it's the three. Here's Jordan. Knight grabs the board. DeAndre Jordan leading the NBA last season in three separate categories. Steve, rebounding, slam dunks, and field goal percentage.
Yeah, those last two are related, of course. You look at his shot chart, and it's basically a green dot right around the basket. And pretty much all of his attempts coming right at the rim, mostly on putbacks or lobs.
Now here's Paul. Brandon Knight missing his last shot. A shot by Redick, no good. To Antetokounmpo. Mayo left side. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
And for Jordan, last season with Doc Rivers coming in as coach, his role was clearly defined, laid out in crystal clear fashion. Defense and rebound. The Rivers put high expectations within that role, expecting him to contend for Defensive Player of the Year.
Now here's Paul. Jordan with a screen on Knight. Ball goes in.
Great job. Right at the defense. I like the aggressiveness.
Yeah, he left him no choice but to foul.
Los Angeles shooting their first free throws of this.
And you look at the numbers for this season, guys, from the free throw line. They're shooting 77%.
And guys, that's really an upgrade over how they shot last season. Not a huge upgrade, but an upgrade nonetheless.
And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. Los Angeles on D. Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
I briefly spoke with Jason Kidd. I asked him how he was going to slow down Blake Griffin in this one, and he told me, any way we can. He went on to add that he didn't really have any one answer for Blake because he is such a dynamic player, adding, you see the dunks in the highlight reels, but he can hurt you in a lot of other ways as well. Really, we just have to throw everything we can his way. Guys?
And as always, Doris, thank you. Now, here is Knight. Jabari Parker, unable to get his last shot to go. Shot clock at four. Yes, and Knight with the assist that time. Here in the first quarter, with about 2 minutes gone by, for the Milwaukee Bucks, they come in off the loss to the Thunder in Oklahoma City.
Yeah, it seemed to me their three-point shooting was their own worst enemy in that game, Clark. Even their wide-open looks weren't falling.
Yeah, and I'm sure when they think back on that game, Steve, their main regret is going to be that they didn't get away from the three-point shot early on. They kept going to it. I like the way they're working the ball inside, because when you do that, you get higher percentage shots, and typically good things happen.
And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Mayo with a screen for Knight. Screen by Sanders. And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession. With the pause in the action, let's bring you the list of teams that have been lighting it up over the last 10 games. The Clippers third.
Yeah, what an impressive run for this club. Everybody seems to be scoring well at the same time. This club is really putting up big numbers.
Clippers have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Paul kicks to Barnes, feeds it to Griffin. And he dunks it down.
Boy, I tell you what, the D was way too soft right there, like Jell-O. You got to do better than that.
Clark, he's not the kind of guy you want to get in the way of.
No, exactly. He's a hard man to stop coming down the lane, but you've got to have good position before the play starts.
Now here's Mayo. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against the Thunder in Oklahoma City.
He got some huge points from the foul line, too, Kevin. He was very aggressive, generating contact and drawing fouls.
And he gets it to go. Mayo's got his first bucket in this one.
I'll tell you what, he's made more than a few of those in his career.
Clippers have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far.
last year the Bucks knew that to make the playoffs would be a real stretch. Strange, kind of, consider that the year before, 2013, they had gotten to the playoffs. I just goes to show you, things change quickly.
Now, here's Reddick, following the shot by Chris Paul. Griffin is screen on Mayo. Reddick passes to Paul. Nice concentration to hit the double clutch layup.
And with the defense playing that well, the double clutch is the only way he's going to get that ball off.
Well, as you guys are talking about, the winds of change can stir things up in a hurry in the NBA. And the Bucks are hoping things can change for the better, Steve, just as fast.
Well, luckily, with the pick they got and the changes they made, I mean, they're in a much better position this year. The postseason's still probably a stretch, but not completely out of the question in the Eastern Conference.
Griffin sets the screen for Paul. Just find the shoot. Here's Barnes. Shot is blocked. They get it back. Whoops, there's a 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Bucks trail by four. Knight with it. Tough time getting going against the Thunder. He was a non-factor in that game. Here's Mayo, and he gets the bucket. Mayo's got his second bucket of the night. Now here's Paul. The dish to Reddick. Take the ball. He kicks it to Reddick. At six. Here's Jordan. And there's the whistle. Foul hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. Larry Sanders picks one up.
DeAndre Jordan alongside Blake Griffin, maybe the best game dunker in the league. He has the ability to make spectacular plays every time he gets near the rim.
And for DeAndre Jordan, Clark, between his length and his leaping ability, playing in an 11-foot, 12-foot rim.
I tell you, when I've watched him play, there are times when it seems as though he's overwhelming the 10-foot pass. He really does look that way.
Clippers started out as a good team last year, but they never seemed to be content with what they had. They added vet after vet as the season progressed. It really made some nice additions.
The game now all time. Clippers with the ball. Now Paul, averaging 18 points a game. Jordan sets the pick for Barnes. Into Jordan. It's stolen by Mayo. And it's the Bucks on the break. Moves on to Tecumbo. Tries again. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. And the Clippers' depth was a big help for him in the first round as the bench provided, I think, Mark, a good punch for him against the Golden State Warriors.
You know, that's true, but they just didn't have enough in the tank to get by the Thunder in that second round of the playoffs in what was really, I thought, an entertaining back-and-forth series.
Brandon Knight spent one season at Kentucky, now in his fourth season in the NBA. Still young and a hard worker. Fearless on the court. I think a lot of upside still there for him.
Talk about Brandon Knight's scrappiness. He ended up on some posters trying to make the right defensive play.
I think you and everybody else remembers that DeAndre Jordan dunk. But you got to give him credit. He was trying to make a defensive play and ended up getting posterized. But I like his effort at the end of the court.
Shot clock at three. Parker with the steal. Here's Antetokounmpo. 17 points for him last game against Oklahoma City.
Gigantic game for him at the free throw line. He was initiating contact, really hunting those whistles from the referees.
Now Jordan, Brandon Knight missing on the three. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession.
And now look at Brandon Knight here. He's been a standout for them the past few weeks. The numbers show it. Ninth in free throw percentage, 14th in steals. He's been locked in from behind the arc, guys. He's in the top 20 in the NBA.
Steve, you mentioned his top 10 free throw percentage. I mean, it's really a strong start.
strong part of his game, and he's the kind of guy that if you're defending him, you don't want to foul him. Make him earn him from the field. Don't send him to the line.
And Griffin, here we go. Easy layup after coming off the pick. Griffin's got the game tied up here for the Clippers. Bucks have gone 4 for 9 from the field to start this game off. Parker, a screen on Paul. Knight dishes to Sanders. Back to Knight. Pass to Mayo. In low to Sanders. Oh, and that one, no question. Powered it down.
Nice pass. It's right on target.
Ball with the ball. He feeds it to Redick. From 12, cannot hit. So Milwaukee will take it the other way. Pushing it up and out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Taking a look at Toronto. They like where they stand right now, perched in that topmost position. Of course, Milwaukee, 5.5 games behind.
You know, looking at the Bucks, they've made some nice strides, a good blend in terms of talent. Experience looking really confident to start this season.
Well, you've got to crawl before you can walk. And I'll tell you what, they're walking tall right now. This club playing with a ton of confidence.
Milwaukee in the lead. Paul with the steal. Right side, Griffin. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Making a three-point play.
His presence is very comforting for this team. He's kind of a fallback option for them anytime they need it.
Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Pachulia is checked in for Sanders. Chris Middleton comes in for Antetokounmpo. Jared Dudley's checked in for O.J. Mayer. And Jared Bayless subbed in for Brandon Knight. Big group substitution here for the Clippers. Spencer Hawes is checked in for Jordan. Turkoglu comes in for Matt Barnes. Jamal Crawford, he's checked in for J.J. Redick. And it's Cunningham in for Chris Paul. Here is Bayless. 11 points for him in that last game against Oklahoma City.
And no question, you look at his assist totals. I'll tell you what a nice job he's doing. Really spreading that ball around. Mid-range jumper becomes a pretty high percentage shot for him when he has that kind of space.
The Clippers trail. Crawford outside. Picked by Griffin. Shot off the screen. Crane for 2 points.
That was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that.
There's the pick. And Bayless gets to Middleton. Pass to Bayless. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. Just 4 to shoot. A 3 from Dudley, and the shot is good. First bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3. Clippers have gone 6-12 from the field here in the first quarter. Here is Cunningham. And it's going to be 2 free throws, 2 contact on the shot.
The Milwaukee Bucks are a team that's tried season after season, year after year, particularly recently, to put the best team could manage on the floor. Unfortunately, that type of approach has kind of left them in no man's land, good enough to compete for a title, quite bad enough to draft a potential superstar.
What do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for Milwaukee?
A lot of success from mid-range so far for them, guys. If nothing else works, they can always fall back on the jump shot.
Well, the other thing I like is defensively, turnovers, and that's allowing them to get into transition.
And the Clippers making a change here. Davis is checked in. talk about that no man's land. The Bucks have tried to sign the best players they could, but so often those mid-tier veterans really don't move the needle.
Yeah, but you know, with this year's top pick, and then you got the Greek Freak, Antetokounmpo, I mean, the Bucks have finally acquired a young talent who they think maybe be able to take them to the next level. We'll see.
Crawford's shot is good.
He's fortunate that shot found the bottom of the bucket. It wasn't the highest quality look.
Bucks have gone 7 of 13, just over 50% from the floor. Some good looks. And the dunk by Parker.
Check out the bounce.
Oh, it's bounced to the outs. Clark, how about that?
Yeah.
All right, showing him off right there. Good move.
What does that even mean, Kevin? Bounce to the outs?
Here is Cunningham following the bucket by the Bucks. On the wing, Davis. Shot clock at 6. Crawford, no luck.
Rebound is going to be the focal point for them in this one, though. I can feel it.
Yeah, it's a physical game, and so far the numbers show that they've got the edge on the glass.
Here is Bayless. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for one more.
And you can feel the pattern of this game, guys. They're working it inside, dominating in the paint, getting good shots at will.
Well, 4 of their last 5 baskets, guys, have been of exactly that variety.
For Milwaukee, they have had 2 chances at the line already, making them both.
Well, you look at the numbers, 79% as a team on the season. That's very impressive.
And comparing to the numbers of last season, they've made a bit of improvement. So that's some positive momentum they can look to build on.
Now here's Crawford, now averaging 17 points a game. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
Well, Jamal Crawford has proven that no matter what role he plays, just call him buckets. He can flat out put the ball in the basket. Got to give him a lot of credit, though. He does change his game quite a bit depending on if he's coming off the bench or starting. I think that speaks to his IQ.
And as you said, with Jamal, a lot of players can't really make that change between being a starter or a sub. But he does it so smoothly in such short time, it really adds a lot of utility to this team.
8-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Bayless the pass to Dudley. Parker dishes to Bayless. To the left side wing. Here's Middleton, defended by Jerkle. Spencer Hawes grabs the miss. Here's Cunningham. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Cunningham's got it all tied up now for the Clippers.
The easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce back.
Tie game in Milwaukee. And we'll be back with you for the start of the second quarter when we return.
Next Thursday night, December 18th, Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder go up against Stephen Curry and the Golden State Warriors.
And the second quarter getting underway. No team gaining an edge so far. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Bucks, guys.
They've done a nice job on the offensive boards here, guys. And I think that is the difference in that first quarter. Really pounding the offensive glass.
Well, they set the tone early with their mindset, their tenacity, and their hustle. I mean, that's the way they've come out. And it's served them well.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. And the Clippers, looking at who they've got. CP3 and Jamal Crawford make the back. Davis is out there with Turkle. And it's Hawes, and it's the 5 spot. And Marshall kicks to Bayless. Oh, good with the triple. Now Davis. Looking for his first basket still in this. Now let's go to Doris Burke. Doris?
Yes, Kevin. Chris Paul, as you know, has accomplished so much in the NBA, but he's ready for that ultimate prize. As Paul said, that's the only thing that matters now. At this point in my career, I'm only focused on building for the postseason, because that's where you make your name, and that's where you make your imprint on history. He's looking to add to that wonderful legacy, guys.
He certainly is. Thanks, Doris.
Well, you can see that desire on the court. He's so focused.
The Clippers in the lead. 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter. And it's Paul penetrating. And Davis puts it in. Milwaukee's gone 0-2 from deeper in the second. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
Bayless, the pass to Marshall. Let's it go from deep. And Bayless with the basket, the assist from Marshall. Bayless has got his first 3 points of the game.
Oh, he's going to keep banging those home if you give him that much space.
The Clippers shooting 59% up to this point. They're working for great shots, and they're hitting them. Paul kicks to Crawford. Back to Paul. They set the pick. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Chris Paul, arguably the league's best point guard. And he does have the best player efficiency rating of any point guard in the history of the Raiders. Future Hall of Famer, this is an all-time great to watch him play right now.
Can you talk about Chris Paul's statistical resume? That often overlooks his defense. He's a perennial All-NBA defense selection over the last 7 years or so. He's a lead at both ends.
And Chris Paul, such a scrappy defender, Clark, the league leader in steals per game for four straight years.
He's got such quick hands. Really what makes him so dangerous defensively is his anticipation. I've watched him off the ball a lot defensively. And he just anticipates where that pass is going. And he gets there right in front.
Here's Antetokounmpo looking for his first basket still in this one. Shot clock at two. No one near Mayo as he lets it go. That ball. Great assist by Marshall. It's all knotted up. And here is Paul. 5 points in the game. The feed now to Reddick. Three-pointer. And the basket good. Reddick's got himself going there. His first points of the game in the deep ball.
You know what, guys? He can really light it up from the perimeter at times.
And Marshall kicks this in. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. After a 2012-13 season in which Larry Sanders received the third most votes for most improved in the league, not to mention a four-year, $44 million extension for the Bucks. Steve, a lot was expected last season.
Yeah, and unfortunately, a lot was not delivered. Injuries and various off-the-court issues kind of made it a season to forget for Sanders. So this year will be one of redemption. He needs to find that form from a couple of years ago.
And Sanders, you know, tearing a ligament in his thumb during an off-the-court scuffle early in the season, it cost him 6 weeks. And he just put together his best game of the season when a stray elbow fractured his right orbital bone and put him out of commission once again. Tough break. Some of it self-inflicted, some of it bad luck.
Reddick dishes to Jordan. Six to shoot. Here's Griffin. Puffs in the layup for two. A five-point Clipper lead.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
I think it's time to make some adjustments defensively, Clark. I mean, what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
And Marshall kicks to Mayo. Here's Middleton, covered by Barnes. Right side Mayo. Here's Sanders, and good work on the boards that pick up the second chance points.
Guys, he's actually indefatigable. He never gives in, never gives up on a play, and that's what it takes to be a great offensive rebounder. He's got to be relentless.
And for Sanders, the injury is unfortunate. I think some of the offensive decision makers are more of a concern. A big part of their future. They can rely on
him. Pass to Reddick. Deep. Shot's good. Griffin making the play. Reddick's got a pair of triples in the second now for the Clippers. Bucks trailed by six. And Marshall kicks to Antetokounmpo. Sanders with a screen on Griffin. Screen by Sanders. And he gets
the layup possible.
Los Angeles calls timeout. Steve, a silver lining to last season for the Bucks, the surprising play of their rookie, the Greek freak, Antetokounmpo.
You know, the youngest player in the NBA last season made a huge leap, and the potential is just incredible. The wingspan, the length, the speed. He has a chance to be special.
Milwaukee making a switch. Knight's checked in. And stolen by Knight. Here's Mayo. The Clippers grab the miss.
Had a pretty good look at the basket, but defensively they did a nice job rotating, forcing the miss.
And for the Milwaukee Bucks, you might say it's been 4 decades since they've had a truly transcendent talent. Still early, but the guy they call the Greek freak has that potential. I mean, at his size with his perimeter skills, the sky is the limit for Giannis.
Mayo with a screen for Knight. Screen by Sanders. It's good, and the Clipper lead is cut down now to just 4 points with the baskets from Brandon Knight.
Well, he wasn't fazed at all by the bigger man on him. On the low block, I thought he might be.
You know, Steve, I thought maybe he'd prefer to bring him out to the perimeter, but whatever works, go to it.
And you look at the frame. 6'9 on draft day, 7 feet. He's still growing. He could be over 7 feet taller all of a sudden. He's got good ball handling skills. He could actually be an elite talent.
Here's Griffin. And there's the pass to Barnes. Jordan dishes to Griffin. Barnes sets a screen for Griffin. Over in the corner, Paul. Missed even after all those chances. Bucks trailed by 4. Right with it. Right now averaging 17 points a game. Shot is long.
Well, he's been off his game this quarter just a bit. Hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go so far.
And that one's good. Barnes. Now, here is Knight. He dishes it to Middleton. Kicks to Antetokounmpo. Mayo with a screen on Paul. It's O.J. Mayo on the wing. Yes, and Knight with the assist that time. That's now 8 points for O.J. Mayo.
You know, he's knocking down his shots today, but it hasn't really translated to the scoreboard yet.
This is Peretti. Back the ball. Right side, Griffin. Antetokounmpo pulls it in.
Had to do there was just stay close to him, and he did.
Feeds to Middleton. Sanders passes to Antetokounmpo, and yes, sir, that one drops. Antetokounmpo's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Boy, after having a tough time in the first, he's managed to turn it around nicely this quarter.
LA's gone 2 for 5 from 3-point land since the end of the first. Jordan, the screen. Griffin gets to Jordan. And he crossed body contact. Looked like a blocking foul, and he was in the shooting motion. So he'll head to the free throw line.
Terry Sanders, mostly an at-the-rim finisher at this point in his career. Making complete plays off pick and rolls. His explosiveness, his length, I think really allows him to throw it down over the top of the defenders.
And for Larry Sanders, you know, he's not the most effective player in isolation situation, but supposedly he's been working to expand his offensive repertoire, focusing on his mid-range shot and driving to the basket. We'll see if Fruit shows up in his work.
Looking at he's out there now for the Bucks. Parker comes in for Antetokounmpo, and Dudley subbed in for Chris Middleton. Clippers leading by 3. He lobs up the alley-oop pass. Pettit with it. He's picked up by Parker. With a screen on Dudley. A stupendous finish in traffic. Cunningham's got 8. And Larry Sanders might be best served working on his free throw shot, Steve, shooting under 60% for his career and well under 50% last season.
No question. But, Kevin, I think the Bucks, first and foremost, they hope he can recover his shot blocking form and rebounding 2 seasons, but that's what they really need out there.
Okay, well, let's check in with Doris Burke reporting from our sideline in this game. Doris, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Doc Rivers trying to help this Clippers team to the mountaintop. And Chris Paul said, I've never had a coach that wants to win as bad as I do until Rivers. Rivers said, I'm just here to try to win. I always tell our players there's no guarantee to it. You have to be willing to get your heart broken. Gentlemen.
He's getting him to lay it all on the line. Doris, thank you. Reddick, a good look, and he tries off the glass, but it's no good. Bucks trailed by 5. Here's Knight, and foul harder that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2.
Brandon Knight last season traded for the other Brandon Jennings. They swapped teams, and Knight ended up with the Bucks. So far, so good. Knight, 2 years younger, and he had his best season yet.
For Knight last season, you know, he upped his rate of scoring and assists, all while lowering his turnovers. That's a nice combination there, showing promise as the Bucks' point guard of the future.
And that one falls for Knight. And Brandon Knight regarded as something of a combo guard coming into the league, a shooting guard's game, Steve, and a point guard's body.
Yeah, but it's encouraging to see his progress and improving his assist-to-turnover ratio every season and with his work ethic. I think he has a chance to make that adjustment to the point guard position.
Well, Bayless has checked in for the Bucks. And here's the fast break. Knight beaten away. Goes back up. Parker, right side. Kicks to Bayless. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. Crawford against Dudley. The dish to Bayless. 5 on the clock. And stolen by Redick. And pushing it up. Here's Los Angeles. Crawford leading the charge. Knight dishes to Bayless. Back to Knight. Get it to Dudley and does. Now Bayless. And it's rejected. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. We should take this chance now to go to the Real Stance, Real Scores, from the Real NBA and run down the top free throw shooters. Take a look at Bayless, the best in the NBA. You put him on the line and it's nearly automatic. And of course, Jamal Crawford.
Neither one of these guys is going to waste an opportunity for the foul. It's not going to happen.
Here is Cunningham. 8 points for him. Showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying hard to get back into this game like this.
Yeah, definitely a jam with emphasis. A big apostrophe or exclamation point. How about maybe even a question mark?
Well, you know what the questions are about now. It's their defense, that's for sure.
Pass to Hahn. Crawford outside. Here's Cunningham. Oh, good on the triple. Trailed by 5. Bayless dishes to Knight. He kicks to Bayless. Goes up the baseline. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Reddick's got his 3rd rebound tonight. And the officials signal the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. Davis has checked in for the Clippers. And here is Knight. He's got 6. Now 8 seconds separate the 2 clocks. Parker outside. And here's Dudley for 3. This is it to Bates. He feeds it to Dudley. And Bayless kicks to Knight. Pointers off the mark. It'll count. Can't get it to go. Close game as we wrap up the 2nd quarter. Clippers lead by 5. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris. after the first two quarters. Milwaukee with the ball, trailing by five.
You know, one story that didn't get a lot of press last season, 2 days after the Bledsoe trade, he'd been going to the ship and trying to back out of it. Rivers actually threatened to quit before their ownership back in.
Titan Mayo, man the backcourt. On to Chikumbo, is out there with Parker, and it's Sanders in at the five, roaming the paint. That's the five to begin the second half for Jason Kidd. And it's Paul penetrating. Shot clock at six. Right wing. Here's Barnes. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. J.J. Redick, that shakeup must have been tough. His contract with the Clippers was contingent on the trade.
And Kevin, reportedly, Doc Rivers leaned on ownership pretty hard, saying, hey, I shook hands on this. Don't make it look bad here. Our reputation's at stake. It all worked out, but a reminder of the Clippers. Rather disappointing.
He hits the second from the line.
Really a good glue guy. Rebounds, defends. He's got better with his outside shot, and he can really run the lane. And he's always had a toughness and a fearlessness that I think a lot of coaches love.
Mayo drives in. Parker passes to Mayo. DeAndre Jordan grabs the miss. Jordan's got 8 rebounds in this game. And plus minus measurements. Matt Barnes rates him 31.
Not surprised by that, Kevin. He brings so much energy over the floor. He does a lot of those little intangible things that don't always show up on the stat sheet.
Antetokounmpo dishes to Sanders. Here's Knight. And the shot counts. He's fouled. It's a chance for a 3-point play.
Getting off on the right track here early to start the half with some penetration.
The Bucks have missed 2 free throws in the game, going 5 for 7. That one misses for Knight.
It's been a nice game for Knight. He has 8 points. He's come up with a couple of nice steals today, too.
Well, he's been playing a very energetic brand of defense, Mark. You gotta love it.
And that one's good.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Bucks trailed by 5. It's gone in this third quarter now. And out of bounds is Los Angeles gains possession.
And now look at Brandon Knight here. He's been a force for them over the past month as you take a look at the league rankings. He's putting up 17 points a game, 5 assists, and 3 rebounds. And you really can't find much fault with him as far as his performance has been.
Yeah, he's been very, very dependable, steady, doing pretty much everything they've asked him.
That's good. And now a 7-point Clipper lead.
Well, this is what he does. He's shooting it well. He's scoring a lot of their points, getting them in front.
Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Here's Sanders, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2.
You know, the less said about the Bucks at home this last year, the better. It was a season to forget. And their play at home, very forgettable.
The Bucks with just 10 wins all year at home a season ago. They knew it would be a tough year, but I don't think they thought it would be that bad.
No good on that one. Well, the Bucks had a lot of problems in a lot of different areas last season.
And some distractions off the court as well. Even when you play at home, if you don't have a competitive roster and have distractions, then that's a recipe for big struggle.
Clippers got a lot of road wins last year. Maybe it was due to how explosive they could be coming out of that.
Griffin goes in. The Clippers scoring again.
Well, he could have earned some style points there, but he really don't need to use the fadeaway when he's that vital.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. And this part of the game always a Golden State focused, and while the coach goes over the game plan, these players are getting a much much-needed chance to rehydrate and refuel with Gatorade. And guys, we know the drill well, all three of us drinking the Gatorade too.
Yeah, no question. Right. I mean, Kevin, people have no idea the fatigue that can set in during a telecast. So it's important for us to stay hydrated all day.
Clark, you're always hydrated.
Yeah, I try to be, but it's usually with a combination of H2O and Gatorade.
I love Gatorade. And look at Steve, that Gatorade shirt on.
Yeah, he's really immersed in the Gatorade. Yeah.
Gotta love it.
Well, the Clippers, as you said, Clark, ended up with 23 road wins last year, in part because they played so well after the All-Star break.
Well, they'll make adjustments, and when you can explode for points like the Clippers can, you're never out of a game, and I like their blend of youth and veteran experience.
Seems like a nice balance. You're right. That's a good point.
They do have a good, healthy balance between those two.
And the second free throw, good.
Jabari Parker, self-described obedient kid growing up in Chicago, maintained a 3.7 GPA through high school. Even so far as to say he had lower self-esteem in his younger days. You don't often hear about that from NBA athletes, but it's a reality. Believe me, I see these guys, and they often aren't as confident as you might think. But there's no reason for this guy to doubt his worth now, especially on the basketball court.
Here's Griffin. A great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got four assists in the game. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Mayo drives in. And as humble as Jabari Parker seems off the court, Clark, he seems like one of those guys who flips a switch when he steps on the floor. Great motor, terrific hunger, real competitive.
Yeah, extremely competitive and confident and assertive. His talent, and you add those attributes, you've got a guy that looks like he could be a potential all-star star.
That one is off. O.J. Mayo in his seventh year in the NBA really just seems he's never been able to truly improve, guys, from his rookie year.
Well, yeah, if anything, last season he took a big step backwards, Kevin. I mean, with his field goal percentage, passing, his rebounding all down, I'm not sure he was in great shape either.
Griffin kicks to Paul. Jordan sets the pick for Paul. Here's Griffin. Bucks trailed by 11.
And the Milwaukee Bucks took a bit of a gamble on O.J. Mayo's upside with that 2-year, $44 million deal last season. The early returns, somewhat discouraging, but let's see how it plays out the rest of the way before we make a final judgment.
Paul goes in. And that'll be Milwaukee as it goes out of bounds. Bucks retain possession.
That was an awfully risky pass, guys. Lucky it didn't wind up as a steal.
Well, it nearly did wind up as a steal, but no harm done in the end. They hang on to possession.
Knight for three.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly.
On offense, here are the Clippers. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Oh, and they get no way in the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. That one's good, and the Clipper lead is cut to just 9 points on the basket from Parker.
Mayo's disappointing season was crystallized in a much-circulated video of him bending over to tie his shoelace while the other team went 5-on-4. He's got talent. Sequences like that have to be cause for concern.
Barnes passes to Paul. Jordan with a screen on Knight. Shot clock at 6. Over to the left wing. Nobody near Barnes. And the Clippers miss again. The Bucks have gone 3 of 8 so far in the third quarter, looking to lock in their rhythm. Here's Knight. Boy, that looked like goaltending. Yes, it is. And so they will award the basket there.
He got there late, but you do have to like the aggressiveness to go after the block. But that one's going to count.
And some stats here, guys, the scoring breakdown for the Clippers.
Well, I got to say, one thing that stuck out all game is the consistent penetration they've got.
The other thing that's been huge for them is their points in the paint. They're getting the ball inside and converting on a regular basis.
Chris Middleton's checked in for Parker.
that Allen Iverson was the most influential player ever. Interesting. Most probably would have said Jordan.
He's gone. 3 for 4 from the line. First free throw is good. And the Bucks making a change here. Marshall's checked in. So he picks up just one from the line that time. Griffin. No luck. They battled on the glass, but couldn't knock it down. Marshall with it. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Mayo dishing to Antetokounmpo. Now the feed to Marshall. Pass to Middleton. Shot from 12. And the rebound goes to Griffin. Griffin's got rebound number 8 now on the night.
We talk about Allen Iverson's influence. You know, Chris Paul wears the number 3 jersey in honor of Iverson. Paul was about 10 years old when the answer started his NBA career. So, huge influence.
Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. Los Angeles with another miss. Bucks trailed by 7. No one near Mayo as he lets it go. Off target from 3-point range. You look at Chris Paul and Allen Iverson. What similarities do you see there?
Well, really just size. That's the only thing. Allen Iverson is a speed merchant. Chris has tremendous and deceptive speed. No stronger, more of a quarterback. AI was just a flat out killer. And the guy did some amazing stuff for a long time. He was 6 feet tall. Good buckets on guys. I hadn't seen this. And Isaiah Thomas was shot.
And Marshall kicks to Mayo. The pass to Marshall. Almost, but it rolls out. Clippers leading by 9. Now here's Barnes. 7 points in the game. And that one is hammered home. Now they're just going to town on.
Yeah, you think these defenders would have done a little more to put a stop to that stuff, Kevin. But so far, no trouble.
Well, phenomenal aerial assault there, fellas.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee.
J.J. Redick acquired by the Clippers going into last season. Great fit, but injuries really held him back. First surgery to repair ligaments in his wrist, then a bulged disc in his lower back. Ended up playing just 35 games in the regular season.
But Julia, he's checked in for the Bucks. Dudley comes in for O.J. Mayo. Clippers have gotten half their shots to drop in the second half. Up to this point, going 7-14. Here is Cunningham. He's got 10. Right side, Davis. Davis with a screen on Dudley. Crawford drives in. A timely screen gave him a step, and he took it all the way. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. Milwaukee's getting blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0-3. And Redick, we're out for the injuries on baseball for the best season of his 8-year NBA career.
Kevin would have been a career high in points per game. Great efficiency for Redick as well. He flourished playing alongside former ACC rival CP3 this fall.
Crawford outside. There's a screen. Wing Davis in the corner. Cirkelou misses the three.
Nobody near him. No one will make that one.
Bradley the pass to Marshall. Crawford with the steal. Shot no good. The Bucks go the other way with it. And this is the first season matchup for them against this Clippers team. Here's Middleton. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Clippers leading by 8. Turkaloo outside. Kicks it to Crawford. Crawford right side. Knocked away. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And that one's good. He's got 12. Milwaukee is on 1 of 4 in three-point shots here in the third. Marshall dishes to Pachulia. Feeds to Marshall. Over in the corner, Dudley. The three-pointer, no good.
It's been a great day for them on the boards. It's definitely been a major factor in building this big lead.
And, you know, from a numbers standpoint, the advantage might not be that large, but they have been manhandling them inside.
Shot clock at six. It's Crawford with the drive. Puts up a three. Cunningham's shot is off. Bucks trailed by 10. Here is Antetokounmpo, guarded by Hawes. Here's Crawford, and a strong finish with two hands.
Well, this is how you completely rattle an opponent's rhythm.
Yeah, you know, such terrific on-the-ball defense to trigger the transition opportunity.
And it wasn't just the tough D, it was the exclamation point they put on the fast break with the slam.
Lovely and Turkaloo. Rebound, Milwaukee. Now Marshall. Dishes it to Pachulia. He's good with the little jumper in close. Pachulia's kept fighting.
Very high quality shot. Can't get enough of those.
Here is Cunningham. 12 points for him. 30 seconds left to play in the third. Davis with the bucket. And the Clippers lead by 12.
Solid screen right there that freed him up for the jump shot.
The Bucks shooting about 42% so far. And Marshall gets to Middleton. Dishes it to Pachulia. Pass to Dudley. Fires the three. Can't get it to go.
Boy, I tell you what, the complexion of this game would be completely different. Shot the ball anything like he's capable.
And he makes the first. Milwaukee making a switch. Both of them. Here is Bayless. With one on the clock. Got it off in time, but it's no good. Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Los Angeles on top. They lead by 14.
Tune in Wednesday, December 17th. Mark Gasol and the Memphis Grizzlies go up against Tim Duncan and the San Antonio Spurs. You don't.
And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
Well, we might as well call it the State Farm Play of the Game. This is just a marvelous piece of coordination between two teammates, completely in sync on the alley-oop.
Clippers leading by 14. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Blake Griffin down low and DeAndre Jordan. CP3 at point with Redick there at the back. And it's Barnes at the small four. Here's Milwaukee now. Knight kicks to Bayless. Here's Parker. Pachulia the pass to Parker. Bayless dishes to Parker. Kicks it to Bayless. And here is Knight. Now the dish to Bayless. Down to five on the shot clock. Here's Parker. It's good from about 19 feet. Fourth quarter of basketball. We're about a minute into it. And so here are the Clippers. Passes to Redick. From 10 feet out, another one falls for the Clippers.
And they got the most out of that possession, guys.
Bucks trailed by 16. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Knight kicks to Parker. Good on the shot, a bit long that time.
Such a solid performance from them inside. Their rebounding has been terrific.
Yeah, that's just one of the few things that have gone their way today.
Redick with it. Jordan the screen. There's the clock. They'll get another chance. He feeds it to Barnes. Rebound, Milwaukee. Outside Mayo. Kicks to Parker. Back to Knight. Here's Bayless. Offensive rebound. Pachulia makes it off the glass.
You know, that putback's about as easy as it's going to get. You have to put a body on someone down there.
Well, no box out. That's the result you get right there.
Ball outside. Griffin sets the screen for Paul. The feed to Jordan from 10 feet out, and the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. And the Clippers lead by 16. For Milwaukee, they've gone 2-for-5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter.
Well, this last season was the Clippers' 30th in Los Angeles. For a team that's long played in the Lakers' shadow, for the second season in a row, the Clippers were the best team in L.A.
Sanders checked in for Pachulia. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Los Angeles calls timeout. Milwaukee had a tough time last night with pretty much everyone, Clark, and they really struggled against the rest, as you might expect.
Yeah, well, they struggled against everybody because, again, this is a team in serious rebuild mode, young and not overly talented. That's a recipe for not being able to win many games, east or west.
The Bucks making a switch here. Ante DeCumbo's checked in. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Kevin, Doc Rivers was just addressing the plan with his team. He wants to make sure they stay assertive and aggressive on the offensive end, saying, I don't want to sit on this lead. Let's build on it and not give them a chance of coming back. Guys?
All right, Doris.
Only 3 wins for the Bucks against the rest of last season. Wow. They got shut out entirely by the Southwest Division.
And he knocks down the first one.
Well, the Bucks weren't the first team from the East to get beaten up by the West in really a down year in the Eastern Conference. And they won't be the last team to suffer that same fate. It's not surprising that that's how it played out. Look at the game for Redick. He's got 13 points, and he's got 9 points from behind the arc.
Yeah, that's been an important part of his game today. He's made his open looks.
Parker passes to Knight. Onde Tecumbo kicks to Mayo. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. Shot clock at 6. Here's Knight. No good. Paul with the defensive effort.
Great job defending the hoop there.
So important to have good presence defensively inside.
Yeah, he got whacked. There shouldn't be much to beat on that one.
Yeah, that was a straightforward as it gets, guys. From the line in the first half, but they've turned it around here, and it's helped them secure the lead. I mean, free throw shooting is important when you're trying to pad a lead.
Good. 18 points for Jabari Parker.
Yeah, he's been the key cog in their offense with the way he shot the ball.
His percentage today, beyond impressive. Certainly not his fault. The score is what it is.
Paul again tonight. Redick is in the corner. this one.
And he continues to search for his rhythm. It's eluded him to this point.
Jordan against Martin. Off target on the 15-footer.
Great close out there, forcing the errant shot.
Well, he made it a tough shot again. He didn't give up on it, and he got a hand up.
Barnes dishes to Griffin. Got a piece of it. And oh, here we go, Knight. Nobody back. Rips down the breakaway shot.
Once he took off, it looked like the defense had no interest in heading in his way.
That's one where you just give up the 2 points and move on.
Griffin. Milwaukee with the rebound. Sanders has got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Mayo, the best to Antetokounmpo. DeMayo. Pass tonight. Shot clock at 6. Blake Griffin pulls it in. Griffin's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
Considered by many to be the most NBA-ready of any rookies. The son of an NBA player, he's got a great IQ for the game, shooting, pass, and great character, too. He's humble, grounded, very committed.
Well, and Parker, maybe the most skilled and well-rounded freshman in college basketball last year. Played a number of positions. Parker, where do you like him best? Watch a lot of film on him. Small forward, power forward, what's his fit?
I really think he's just a forward. You look at the opposition you're facing. Where do you have the best advantage with him? His conditioning level has to be at the highest level for him to be most effective. I love his overall package. Shooting, rebound. I think he's going to be better defensively as long as he commits to conditioning his body.
And little to no chance of that shot going in.
Yeah, that was a tough one right there.
Here's Redick. And it's Larry Sanders with the rebound. Sanders has got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Parker kicks tonight. There's the pass to Antetokounmpo. It's O.J. Mayo on the wing. Here's Sanders. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. And the first one at the line is good.
Well, at this point, early in the season, still so much optimism for the season ahead. We all have our predictions, but there are always going to be some surprises out there, some surprise teams. And that's why we say all the time, that's why they tee it up and play the game.
That one misses. And early on, while teams are still shelling, still knocking the rust off, Steven creates kind of a period.
Yeah, this is often where you'll see some upsets. You know, the talent you have on paper is one thing, but you got to produce on the court. I mean, teams really just getting put to their first test.
And the first one drops.
First half. He's hoping to be a little bit more active and aggressive here and draw some fouls here in the second.
Knight against Paul. Knight dishes to Mayo. And it's Mayo again
place there, Kevin, of him making a pass to a spot, and then he let his teammate run right into it. Well executed.
Kicks to Sanders. Feeds it to Knight, and Chris Paul picks up the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Antetokounmpo passes to Sanders.
I think they've got to get back to what they were doing in the first half if they want to win this game. I mean, they're shooting it poorly, and that's really due to the fact that they've not been as sharp in their execution.
Pass to Antetokounmpo. Back to Knight. Sanders sets the screen for Knight. Knight on the wing. The three. And that one's good. Knight's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Well, it took him a long time to get that three-point range. Maybe this will get him going.
Clippers leading by 13. Here's Redick. And so he owns a trip to the line. Officials on the contact, and he'll shoot two. For Redick. He hits both from the strike.
You know, he's as close to a sure thing as you can possibly have when he steps to the line.
Here's the screen. Right on the wing from downtown. And another three for Milwaukee.
Well, I'll tell you what, since the beginning of the fourth quarter, the three-point shot really just been there for them. Everything's fallen.
Yeah, the touch from downtown is right on point.
Ball outside. Out left to the wing. Six to shoot. Puts up the baby hook. Tried to bank it in, but he missed it.
Defense did just enough to throw him off that shot.
Antetokounmpo and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Chris Paul picks up that one.
Last season was a tough one for the Bucks, but for the man they call the Greek Freak, it was a great situation. Able to play big minutes and took his lumps early, but got a chance to be an excellent player.
And the veterans on the team have really embraced G-Bo, as they call it.
Yeah, Giannis has a really joyful disposition. He knows he's living his dream. But he's also putting in the work to make his dreams a reality. You gotta love that. Remember, he's lived a hard life growing up in poverty. And since his determination to continue over time,
that attitude always serves him. That's pretty much been the norm for them. Getting their points off assists, great ball movement.
Nice rhythm and flow for this team. Tremendous communication and alertness.
Here's Barnes. And he was fouled on the way out. Two free throws now for him. And the first one goes. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Trailed by 11. Timeout called. The Bucks.
They're committing an awful lot of fouls. Most of them are unproductive. Don't want to let guys get easy layups. I understand that. But this could turn into a parade to the foul line.
All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
Hi, Kevin. Jason Kidd was just going over the plan with his team. He told the team he wanted to run their offense through Parker. Coach emphasized getting him as many touches as possible, saying he is going to be one of the guys to carry us the rest of the way. The next thing he talked about was the pace he'd like to see them playing at offensively. He wants it to be a fast-paced game, pushing tempo all the time. A few late-on-the-fly adjustments as the situation gets more desperate than that. It's going to be a tough hill to climb, guys.
And thanks for that story, boys.
Doing a great job here in the second half.
And the second one of two is good. That will push the lead to double digits. Milwaukee has gone 3 of 4 from downtown here in the fourth. Sanders with a screen on call. Knight pitch to Antetokounmpo. Here's Sanders, and he jams it with authority.
And they needed a run to get back into this game, and they got it.
And a good defensively and offensively. It's been a terrific stretch ball.
And Griffin with the score. He assists for Redick. And that's now 21 points for Blake Griffin. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. They're trailing by 10. There's 1:38 left in the fourth. Side Mayo, he dishes it tonight. Launches a three. The Clippers grab the miss. Barnes has got 4 rebounds now tonight.
Their rebounding has been off the charts today, guys. Reason number one, this game is out of hand.
Exactly. When the score is right where you'd expect it to be, when the battle on the boards is that lopsided.
Into Jordan. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll throw to the line. Free throw, no good. Bucks trailed by 12.
And so only one team answered the bell tonight. Not a monster blowout by any means, but still a double-digit victory for the Clippers.
And Clark, their hard work on the glass paid off.
You know, they both are excellent rebounding teams. I thought it was a tough battle underneath both ways.
So looking at the season total, this will be their 17th win.
And tonight they took the time they needed. Made the plays they had to, when they had to, and that's why they're going up one zip in their 3-game season series against the Bucks.
Nobody really saw a performance like this coming, but it was a big-time game for Blake Griffin. And the way he rebounded here surely was a spark for the team. I'll tell you what, he was securing everything that came off the iron.
35 seconds left in the fourth quarter. This game looks like they've got it just about wrapped up.
You're exactly right. I mean, take care of the ball, work the clock. It's a wrap.
Yep, nice game. Now, here's Redick. Defense is right there. Can't cash in on the 10-foot jumper. Here comes Brandon Knight. Here's Antetokounmpo. No good from outside. Got the defender off his feet with the pump fake, but couldn't knock it down. He lobs up the alley-oop pass.
Well, you relish these sorts of road games where you come in and you get the job done.
In a long schedule with the kinds of pressure of travel and tough opponents throughout the season, it's always good when you play a game like they have here.
So the Clippers winning this one easily. Some days, Clark, everything goes right for a team, and they just had one of those games.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, these guys played a great all-around basketball game here.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris.
Chris, we got to see Lob City in full effect here tonight. Seems like everyone on this team is really on the same page right now.
Exciting. Exciting. It was something good for the fans to be excited about. But at the end of the day, we got to win.
It's always about that, Chris. Thank you. Kevin?
Doris, thank you. And for Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke, and the rest of our great 2K Sports crew.